What's up, guys? Welcome to another episode of the vlog. Today is a very special day, which is going to lead into a very special weekend. See, today, February 24th, my daughter turns 18 years old. So she was born 18 years ago in Maryland, and one of the things that, and you know, obviously 18 years is a long time, but one of the things she's wanted to do for a long while is run a specific half marathon. Now, she wanted to do this back when she was 14 years old. She wanted to have the Disney Princess half marathon be her first half marathon. Unfortunately, Disney had a rule that you couldn't do a half marathon unless you were at least 16 years old. Well, naturally, as a 14-year-old wanting to run a half marathon, she was kind of devastated. We ended up finding another half marathon in 2018 that she was able to run and complete under 3 hours. Of course, she was 14 at the time. I ran with her. It was in New Orleans. And then we went to Disney World for that trip. I'm sorry, Disneyland for that trip. So taking her to California. So this year she turns 18 years old, and this happens to be the weekend of the Disney Princess half marathon. Always around her birthday, but this is the first live one in a couple years, and now that she's able to actually run it. So tomorrow morning we are getting in the car at around 5 o'clock a.m. and we are driving straight to Orlando so we can go to Disney World and we can run it. So you are going to be along with us for the race, for the weekend. You're going to get some good footage because I will be using my action camera. I am bringing this and I'm bringing the M50 to go along with us. Now, there's not going to be a whole lot of lessons, a lot of talking. This week is about race prep. Now, I've had a couple big swims so far this week. I had one powerful bike. I have a brick this afternoon. Nothing out of the ordinary. And the brick is the run is a tempo run. So it's got a lot of like race pace intervals with it for about, it's like a 45 minute run. So we have a 1 hour 45 bike, 45 minute run today. Tomorrow we get a rest day. And Saturday, I have a light, just kind of a shakeout workout. We're gonna go around the parks. And then Sunday is race day. So, I'm not gonna show you much of today because today is not what this episode is about. It's about the race, because one of the goals I have for this race is obviously another PR. I want to beat my last half marathon's time of 1:56. I was lucky enough to get into a corral early enough. Like, so it's based on bib number, okay? Their bib number, because my wife and McConaughey and Mackenzie are running this with this race this year. So their bib numbers are like 1,300. Mine's 277. So I'm pretty close into the front of the race crowd as we get started. So I'm gonna get to go and run while it's still kind of dark out. So you're gonna see, if you've never seen a Disney race in the morning, it's actually kind of cool. Everything is still very well lit up. This is the first time I'll be running through the Magic Kingdom. So we're gonna get a chance to see the Magic Kingdom in the daylight. And then the Magic Kingdom when you're running through it at 6 o'clock in the morning. So I'll go over all of the race stuff as we get closer to it, when we hit the expo, when we hit Orlando. First, we gotta get to Orlando. So I'm gonna take us to Orlando. You don't need to see the driving vlog, because guess what? It's two roads and they're boring roads. So we're gonna be in Orlando in 3, 2, 1. Three. Okay, so here we are. We are finally at Disney. We're in Animal Kingdom. That's Pandora in the background. You can see the floating mountains. We just got here. It is 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So we're gonna walk around. We're gonna get checked in. I think there's a bathroom break that has to be had. And enjoy the trip, because this whole trip is about just kind of enjoying time off. And then of course the race on Sunday. So what are we doing? Let's find out. interrupt the montage and probably won't do many more clips today until later. But we're at our favorite lunch slash dinner place, Satouli's. This is the best thing for me to get. I get the same thing all the time. It's a sweet potato hash with meat or beef and chicken and a vegetable coleslaw to die for. If you're ever here, you need to eat this. We come here every time. Our favorite place in the Animal Kingdom to eat. So let me eat this. We'll get back, show you a couple more clips of the day, and then we'll wrap up the day. Okay, I'll do a full room tour when we have lights and we can go outside and actually see. But it's your standard room, two big beds, closet space, Keurig, bathroom, all that other stuff. I don't have to give you the specifics. Flat screen TV like every other damn room has. Big money is out that door, but we'll have to wait till morning to see that. So it's a little dark. I'll see you in the morning. What's up? It is the next morning. It's Saturday, about 7:40-ish, and I'm going outside. I'm about to go down and do a 15 minute shake up run. Just kind of, you know, loosen everything up, make sure I'm not stiff from the drive, lactate's flowing, so lactic acid built up in the legs, and just kind of loosen them up, getting the blood moving, all right? But walked outside the staircase, my room's like two doors in from there, and this is what we're paying for when it comes to our hotel room. Let me see, I can't flip the screen. So I'm gonna record a new clip, so give me 2 seconds and boom. Walk outside our room, and we got the savanna. We paid for a savanna view. So we got giraffes, we got a whole bunch of other animals out there. Now they should be, hopefully, walking all through around here. Like our room's on that side of the thing. But to be able to come outside and see the giraffes just chilling, everybody's just waking up this morning, was kind of cool. So I have let the family know. In the meantime, I'm going downstairs to ground level so I can do this 15-minute run. Like I said, it's nothing special. It's 20 seconds fast, 40 seconds recovery, multiple times, a bunch of times. I don't even have the workouts on my phone right now. And then come back. I don't know what we're doing for breakfast, but we got Magic Kingdom today, so shit. I should have went that way. I'm gonna fucking leave me. Oh. Anyway. I didn't go. I gotta find out how to get the hell out of here so I can run. Alright, we're done with the 16 minute run. Nothing special. I'm not even gonna talk about the stats. It was 16 minutes. And yes, before anybody says anything, this is the same shirt I wore yesterday, so, whatever. When I go on vacation, I usually work out in the shirt I wore yesterday. Saves me a shirt. Saves me from packing extra shirts, so, I'm done. It is, it's 8:11, head back into the room, suck and shower, get ready to roll. With today's plans, we're gonna go to the expo, get our bibs, get checked into the race tomorrow. Then we're gonna hit over to Magic Kingdom. So, fun day, but relaxing. We're just walking slowly. Let's see where the day takes us. We're gonna eat light, because last night's dinner was so heavy, it kept me up. I'm feeling it right now, so I'm glad We're gonna eat light tomorrow, or today, and then tomorrow we'll go big after the race. So, all right, getting shower. All right, so we're up. We're ready to go to the expo. We're actually getting. We're ordering breakfast now while the rest of the family gets dressed and ready to go. But I'm outside on the little balcony for our room. I said we come back to this to see what's up. So here's what's outside our room right now. A couple giraffes, an antelope, these big birds, I don't know what they are. There was some vultures over there. Another pack out that way. Something in the back down there. The giraffes are on the move. They're just eating in front of us. So this is the savanna view in the Animal Kingdom Lodge Resort. It's expensive, but Mackenzie wanted to stay here. She was her birthday weekend. And I think that right there justified the cost. Last night's dinner was expensive, but it was justified with the quality of food. I'm a quality guy. If the cost is there, and it lives up to the hype and the expectations, giraffe's taking a piss right in front of me. Cool. Anyway, cost justified. We're gonna go to the expo. So we made it here to the expo. Right now we're at packet pickup for the half marathon. 10K was this morning. I didn't run it. But I was doing a little quick morning shakedown run while they were coming back to the hotel. It's pretty dead here right now. Like, you know, you could almost count on one hand how many people are here. So I got my check-in pass. I'm gonna go get my stuff, my shirt. I'm in the very first line with the bibs 1 to 750 because I am bib number 277. So, I'll be back when we get to the expo. Alright, so here's the shitty part about online registration when you don't do it and other people do it for you, is they type fast and they mistype your name. So, I am not Robert Hale for this race. I am Rob Brent Hale for this race. But I am bib 277, which means I am starting closer to the front early on, and that's good, like I was just telling the guy, because I have to get back to the room to be with this little monster, G.
Hi.
I have to get back to the room quick to be with her, so I have to finish as fast as I can, get on the bus, and get myself back here, or back to the hotel, so she doesn't get into mischief like she's known to do. So feel free to cheer on bib 277, Rob Brett Hale. So here's the medal I'm getting tomorrow. It could be worse. Could be like Cinderella or Tinkerbell or something like that. So I can deal with Mulan. I really can. So let's go check out the course. And once I get up the line, I'll show you the course map.
Every so often. Before when we were in, I think we were pieced together. Now I just call it. I'll
eventually call it. So standard down and back course. Go ahead. So standard down and back for the princess. Started at Epcot, run right to Magic Kingdom, through the castle. I'll put the map here in digital so you guys can see it a little bit better, because I know I kind of look at it really, really quickly. But you start at Epcot, you're running the roads all the way up through to get to Magic Kingdom. Magic Kingdom, you know, Main Street, then you zag through a couple of the worlds. Nothing special, Then you hit the long stretch of just road all the way back to Epcot Center, where you run through a little bit of Epcot, and then you finish. So that is the trek for tomorrow morning. And yeah, so that's that. So we're gonna finish wrap up here with whatever we're doing here, and then we're gonna finally go to the Magic Kingdom next. And I'm not bringing the camera first, so any clips you get will be from the phone. But I mean, I'm not gonna get a whole lot of clips. We're literally just doing the most chill day we can while we recover and get ready to run in the morning. So if I don't show you any more clips of the Magic Kingdom, I will see you first thing in the morning on run day. You saw what I got. That's what we did. I was kind of focusing on being with G and the rest of the family today. So, but we are back in the room. It is late as hell. It's like 10:20. I should have been in bed an hour ago. But Flat Rob is on the bed, ready to go. So, starting head to toe, we got a base sweatband. That's just, you know, just to keep some whatever sweat out of my eyes, obviously. Under Armour, very light shirt here, heart rate monitor watch, headphones. I'm using headphones because I want headphones. It's going to be a lot of open road and a lot of dark and quiet, and I want noise. That's my magic band to get in here. This is my action camera to hopefully it works tomorrow, like it didn't work at the last race. Bib number, and then I got my running shorts and then the compression shorts with the pocket for my phone. My nutrition. This one's going to be pre-race, these two are going to be during the race, and then I opted for these and not the Carbon X's because I didn't like how I felt with the Carbon X's last week. So that's what I'm rocking tomorrow, or in the morning in a couple hours for the race. I should be good to go. The race plan is take the espresso goo by 10 minutes before the race starts, 15, 20, maybe 15 minutes before the race starts. And then every 40 to 45 minutes for the other goos. I don't have a water bottle. I'm just gonna use on-course hydration. It should be Gatorade, and if it's not Gatorade, I'll just get some water. This shouldn't be too bad today or tomorrow. I'm probably not gonna check in before the race because it's gonna be early and Gigi's still gonna be sleeping, but pre-race nutrition is simple. Couldn't get any pancakes, so we got bagels, which is the next best thing. I've got some butter, I've got a knife, bagel, two bagels and butter before we go, and I'm probably gonna bring one on the way just so I could eat it on the bus. But that's basically what I'm going with. So we're gonna hope for the best tomorrow. I'll see you then. So we are at the race. Good morning. It is 4:28 a.m. I'm actually heading to my corral. So I'm going to do my quick warm-up. Connie and Kenzie are at the porta potty. I just don't have to go, and it scares me a little bit. But I took my Imodium this morning. So right here's the finish line. Maybe you can see that. You'll see that a little bit up close and personal a little bit. I'm not gonna record the whole race. I am just gonna record snippets. Every couple miles I'll do something, especially when I get into Magic Kingdom, and because that's the best part of this run as far as I'm aware. So I'm gonna go over there. I found a nice bald spot in the crowd. I'm gonna go hit my warm up, just 10 minutes to loosen up. And yeah, let's get this run over with, man. I'm excited. Just gotta do it, right? So, all right, let me go warm up. I'll see you in a minute. And the home of the brave. About 27 and change. So I got a good pace going. But we're coming up to a spot that we named the Narrows back 12 years ago when we were first here observing our first Princess race because some friends were running there. We're about to, about a half mile or so, we're about to cross under the Narrows. So, I gotta get that on video for my wife. Caution runners, road narrows ahead. So, running through the Narrows, feeling good. We're just crossing mile 5, 45 minutes or so. After this, I'm putting the camera away and running the rest of the way. Thank you.
Alright. Marathon is done. Where the hell's my medal? I had to go over here for that? Shit. Alright. Half is done. Back to the hotel. I'm tired. I gotta get back to get G.
Back to the room, sitting on the balcony, waiting for Gigi to shower. So what I'm doing now, let's go over the run. Was not my best half marathon. I don't know. This, I could not maintain a consistent pace. Like, I started off like nines, and then, you know, I'd go to like 8:50 and then slow down to nines. And like, I couldn't maintain a pace that was like steadily decreasing like I wanted to. My paces were, like, the first 3 miles were great. 908, 902, 851, just like I wanted, just, you know, that steady decline all the way down. But then 904, 9. And mile six, where was it? Mile six was running through the park. And it got a little bit more congested. So it was 919, 916 for mile 7. And then mile 8, like just before mile 8, I took a 3 minute bathroom break. So that one was 1112. And then after that, it was just like 921, 901, 907, 854, 922, 835 that last little bit. And overall, it was like a 916 minute per mile pace. Total time, according to my watch, 202.37. PR would have been 156 and change. Disney PR was 201. So, like, I'm right around that 2 hour mark with Disney races. I have not gotten under 2 hours with a Disney race. But at the end of the day, it wasn't a bad run. The back half was just road. I mean, it was kind of boring. Running through the Magic Kingdom was fun. Again, it got congested a little bit, slowed you down. I think I need a new run. I need to revise my run nutrition, because this is 3 runs in a row where I've had goo and I've had to shit myself. So luckily there was porta potty aplenty on this course. So I was able to, you know, safely duck off and do what I had to do. But all in all, not a bad day. Connie and Mackenzie are still out on the course. As I'm recording this, let's look at them now. I can pull up their locations and roughly estimate where they are. So it's 8 o'clock as I'm recording this. As of right now, it looks like Kenzie is in the final 3 miles. So yeah, she just passed 10 not too long ago. And I know Connie was having a lot of pain in her hamstring, so she said she's slowing down. She's almost at 10 miles, at the 10 mile mark. So they both have like three and a quarter to go, or less. So they're doing good. I expect them to be done in like the next, Kenzie will be done in about a half hour, 40 minutes or so. Connie will be done maybe by 9, and that'll be that. So then it'll just be waiting for them to get home. We'll get back to the room so we can shower and enjoy the rest of the day. So I'll pick up when they get here. And I think we're going to Epcot today to just walk around and take some more pictures. So I'll bring the medal all day. Medal's actually not too bad. It's Mulan 13.1 and it does spin. So I'll hang this one up in the room. Not too ashamed of this. I'm not going to wear that shirt though. That shirt was like lime green and not me at all. So that's definitely things. Yeah, not happening there. But once they get back, I'll do a last minute summary of with Mackenzie because it's her birthday, and then we're just gonna enjoy the rest of the weekend. I think we have Epcot today, and then we're gonna go to Universal tomorrow, and then go home late tomorrow night. So yeah, that's the rest of our weekend. I'm hungry, but I'm not gonna go get anything big for breakfast. I don't want to do the whole mobile order thing, but I might run down and grab something real quick to put in my stomach. So that'll be that. So my feet are sore. That's basically the most pain I'm in. That the bus ride kind of stiffened things up. But all right, enough blabbering for me. I'm gonna go. I've got things to do and stuff, so I gotta wait for them to get home, and I gotta shower. So I'll see you in the last little bit, and then that'll be it for this episode. Thanks for watching. Thumbs up if you like it. Check out whatever's remaining, and don't forget to subscribe if you're not subscribed. See you next week.